I hope the days come easy and the moments pass slow, and each road leads you where you wanna go. And if you're faced with a choice and you have to choose, I hope you choose the one that means the most to you. And if one door opens to another door closed, I hope you keep on walking till you find the window. If it's cold outside, show the world the warmth of your smile. But more than anything, more than anything, my wish.
So I can sit there and be like, what the fuck is that? How does my set start? What am I doing?
And sometimes you just need that little reminder.
And then everything after is spectacular.
Oh, is that
right?
You okay?
Sorry, did I tell you your house was open?
Yes. Okay. Thank you.
His piece is in hard, so it'll be okay.
Yeah, my piece is cake. It's all scary.
It was really hard, and I sucked at it. I messed everything up.
I saw concentration, and I saw your fingers going.
Megan
crazy.
Was like, that is the worst we've ever played it together. And I was like, yeah, that was the worst we've ever played it together.
So how are you feeling, Alex?
Good. I'm feeling good. It's funny, a lot of the other music majors this year have done this thing, and you eat a banana before you perform, and apparently the potassium like helps you not be so nervous. So I ate a banana around 3 o'clock. I popped some Mucinex, so I'm not all like, wah, ha, 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 ha.
You've never heard the banana trick?
I've never heard the banana trick.
How have you never heard the banana trick?
I you have to be on, this is my recital video, baby. I've never heard the banana trick ever in my life.
I eat a banana before every concert.
Did you eat a banana today before Megan's?
No.
There's your issue.
Also, IHOP just made me really sick, so I'm blaming you for that one.
All right, well, it's all my fault, then I'll never buy you lunch again.
It was breakfast.
Whichever.
Because you don't ever eat breakfast.
I do. I did eat breakfast.
So tell me about your date today. What time do you step into your accompanist because you need her desperately bad right now? So tell me about your day.
Well, she had rehearsal this morning at 9 o'clock, so I woke up early, drove her to rehearsal, hung out in the music building, drank water all day long until she was done. Then we got IHOP breakfast because I wanted something. At like 9:45 or so, we got breakfast. And then I ended up going back to my house and just kind of laying around until about 1 o'clock in the afternoon. I went out and got party supplies for later tonight.
Could you clarify party
lots
supplies?
Of candy for people to consume later at my house. So everyone's going to be hyper on candy, right?
Sugar.
Yeah, sugar. And then about 3 o'clock or so, I was showered, my hair was done, I ate my banana, I took my Mucinex, started drinking water, last minute going through all of my music, and then 4:15 I was here, and then I had to wait for the first recital to get finished, but that was my day.
How are you feeling right now?
I'm honestly just feeling really good. I'm like, I think it's going to be great, I love performing, and I think that'll be really enjoyable. I think I'm going to do a nice job. There's a couple of spots that I'm a little nervous about. But, I mean, Aerie's so good that I'm not worried about that at all. Hi, Mom. Come on in.
Hi, sweetie.
How are you?
I'm good. Are you ready?
I am all set. Love you.
Oh, I love you, too.
Thank you for getting all the stuff for the reception. Is it lovely?
You're welcome. It looks fabulous.
How do you like my tie? I brought new clothes.
I
know.
Nice job.
Brand new clothes, right?
All by yourself?
All by myself. Well,
you got a belt? Okay. Yeah,
a full belt and everything. I should have bought new pants because these ones are unbuttoned right now because they're a little tight.
Oh, really?
But the belt's going to handle them up, right?
Well, you have to be able to sing.
Right. I kind of figured the breathing was more important than worrying about my pants.
Mom and Dad, thank you very much for paying for my 5 years of college. Thank you for supporting me, even when the times that I wasn't even sure that I wanted this darn degree. Thank you for supporting me in all the stuff that I've done, in helping me get jobs and other sorts of things like that. I really appreciate everything, and thank you for being here.
Yeah, my parents, I'd like to thank Dr. Dement and Aerie, my accompanist. Without them, this would not have been possible. I mean, Dr. Dement brought me light years from where I used to be, and I mean, Aerie has been so fantastic, and this is her first time doing a senior recital in a long number of years. I don't remember the last time she played for a senior recital. So this is a really special thing for the both of us, and I really appreciate everything that the both of them have done for me and how flexible they've been. And I mean, Dr. Dement is as much of a therapist as she is my voice teacher. So thank you both very much.
Thank you very much for inviting us.
Did you have a Mountain Dew?
I did not, because caffeine is bad for your voice. I haven't had no caffeine.
Oh my goodness. Oh,
no alcohol for the past couple of days.
Boy,
limited my caffeine intake a great deal.
See, there's
a cup of tea?
No,
because
there's caffeine.
Oh.
Yeah.
Just water all day long, because dehydration starts four hours before.
It's a bad thing, too.
It is a bad thing.
And I'm very proud of you, too.
Love you.
All right, son. Do your best.
Proud of everything he's done, and I love him very much. And even through all this bullcrap, it's going to be really awesome.
You're a pain in my butt.
You're the biggest one.
Thank you. Thank you. advocate of the crimes of complete dishonestly of them. Mr. Cool, Mr. Wright, Mr. Know-it-all is through that the future so bright, and I owe it all to you who showed me the light. It's a brand new me. Yeah.
so good.
I was just sitting there during. What? I don't know. It was one of the English pieces. I'm sitting there. I'm like, I'm not getting a single word right.
Okay,
right. Aries got me, so whatever.
Did you have the catching?
Not the English piece.
Really?
I just have like a black t-shirt.
The first thing, the Finzi pieces. The Shakespeare.
Alright.
No? Oh, alright, well. How did I do in the Rosamond? Was I off there?
Okay.
I love you, thank you.
I'll see you after Crowd's Lodge Singers, okay?
Bye, baby. Sorry. What? Oh, my phone in my binder. I feel really, I feel could not have been better in my mind. Like, literally, I wanted everything. I know. And then I thought, am I? No, you were right. See, even you got tricked out by that. But no, I loved it, and I was like, I feel like it was just a circus, but I don't care. What's ahead of that? I mean, did I pass Dr. D? Did I pass?
Yeah.
How about me?
Yeah.
Thank you.
Sam, what are you doing, silly boy?
It wasn't bad, but...
No, it was weird.
Next chapter.
Oh, you are just adorable.
So hard.
Oh, gosh, get out of here. I'll see you in lessons.
Yeah, oh, no, I know.
We'll figure, yeah.
Definitely.
Dr. Dement has, I mean, been the reason that I am so good that I am. So in the coming weeks, we're going to do some music theater rep and just kind of work on that and get some stuff together and see what I can sing
see
and what I can take up to New York.
Can take it.
Yeah, absolutely.
Excellent. This is really fun.
You like that? I got that for Christmas the other year.
That's fun.
Yeah. All right. Let's go meet some people.
Let's go. For you, death is like becomes.
Another turning point, a fork stuck in the road. Time grabs you by the wrist, directs you where to go. So make the best of this test and don't ask why. It's not a question but a lesson learned in time. It's something unpredictable, but in the end is right. I hope you had the time of your life. So take the photographs and still frames in your mind, hanging on a shelf in good health and good time. Tattoos and memories and dead skin on trial. For what it's worth, it was worth all the while. It's something unpredictable, but in the end is right. I hope you had the time of your life.
So I was going to, I was going to do a song from that, but I ended up just, it was good, but it wasn't exactly what I wanted. And I directed Dr. Harwood here at UD my sophomore year. Like, I found some guy who transposed all the music, put it all online, and, you know, illegally got that. And we, like, didn't charge admission, we just did donations. So we raised $1,000 over a 6-show run for a missionary. I'm really glad you guys.
Spectacular.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Yes.
Let me know about dinner and all that stuff.
Yeah, well, we got a...
I didn't even know what was happening.
We got to check the place out.
Nice. I'm really excited. I'm sure you are too.
Really excited for the time.
Go home, take a nap.
Yeah.
Hi.
Congratulations. We have a question.
I have an answer. It might not be the right one.
If we are the pages, we're book is 730 pages, I'd say. So we never see you.
That's great. She's older. She's a graduate student.
Okay.
But she's like kind of going back and getting the graduate degree as like her career sort of change move there.
like our husband is like, you know, some sort of technology worker, you know, thousands and thousands of times.
Unpredictable, but in the end it's right. I hope you had the time of your life.
Good job, Alex. Tonight was fantastic. Best of luck in New York. Hope you had a great time in college, and I love you. You're the bestest brother ever.
It's a more formal event. I mean, this is a great I hope so.
It's something unpredictable, but in the end it's right. I hope you had the time of your life.